Virologists presume that Omicron's distinctive mutations could be from patient zero who might be HIV positive. Does this mean that the virus can cause HIV?
The virologist's presumption is quite right, but I would like to point out at this juncture that the virus involved in a HIV positive person because of the immune suppressive response. But you see, what is important to learn is that the virus is a SARS-CoV-2 virus and the variant of concern. So it will only cause the infection related to SARS-CoV-2, but it will not cause HIV infection because that's a distinctly different type of virus.
B11529 or Omicron has 50 mutations, 30 in the spike protein. Is this true? How concerned should we be?
This is a very important information. In fact, you know, the African scientists have worked very hard on this, studying this virus, Omicron. And when they, you know, discovered this and declared it as variant of concern, that means WHO had declared it as variant of concern. So what was observed that this virus has undergone several round of mutations. And, you know, more around 30 mutations being there at the spike protein level. And most of the vaccines are also, you know, of the spike protein level. That means, you know, which makes the virus much more transmissible. And also, you see, the vaccines are not effective at that point of time, which is a scenario. But we are looking forward towards, you know, in terms of the effectivity of vaccine. And also, in addition to that, it is presumed that there are about 10 rounds of mutation at the level of receptor binding protein also. So which makes the virus, you know, have a place to easily attach to the susceptible host and cause the infection, and which could be more severe in nature. But as of now, the cases what we are getting are more milder in nature as compared to Delta variant.
Is there a need to step up genome sequencing?
See, already the government is very vigilant towards genomic sequencing, and we have got 13 labs which are being, you know, used to do the genomic sequencing under the INSACOG consortium. So it is important to look at from that perspective that as of now, government has prioritized its genomic sequencing as well, along with the other public health interventions. So genomic sequencing needs to be an integral part of our public health intervention so that we are vigilant, because this virus is there which is going to mutate. So we must know which is the new strain which is coming, how infective it is, how severe are the clinical manifestations, whether the vaccine is going to work or not, whether our treatment protocols are going to change or not. So these are some of the important observations. Once we identify the virus, then only accordingly, you know, the virus is watched in terms of its infectivity, severity and transmissibility.